Let me show you how easy it is to break this guy down. So I've already taken the thing off the other end. And, you know, again, I said, you know, I needed some half-inch plywood. I couldn't find any half-inch Baltic. So I just took a couple of my old table saw inserts that I knew were 12 millimeter. And they work just perfect for these metric bolts that I had that have to fit these metric T-nuts that fit in the slots. I have a Festool box to just keep all my Festool stuff in. And so take these guys out. So here's what these little aluminum T-nuts look like. And these guys here. Now I want to take the I want to take my guide piece off the bottom. That's why I had such poor dust control, is because, you know, I'm cutting this and I'm trying to exhaust just through this little thing. These are going to always be your worst dust control setups with a router. Okay, and I remember too, this morning when I did this, I had a mix of Common and Phillips that I dug out of my box, so let me take the commons out first. I'm looking around for a Phillips and I don't really see one, but that's okay because I have my Swiss Army knife and I've got a couple of Phillips on that. But I know I've mentioned this in other videos, but this thing, I know it's expensive. I've said that before too, but the time that it takes to make all these jigs that you use maybe once or twice, if that, and then if you don't use them, then they sit around and they warp and they get moisture in them, and so you waste time making them, and then you waste time in materials, and you're not really able to reuse them. Not real often. So this thing is just an amazing tool to keep from wasting materials, keep from wasting time, and when you're done, you just break it down and put it in its little storage cubby, and then it's ready to go the next time. Box is pretty disorganized right now, so I'm not really fretting where I put that stuff. And again, I got some T-nuts here. And now I need to just break the It's got the really nice graduations on it with metric readout. I use them to get close, but I generally either use, like you saw me use with my digital calipers, or I'll cut a scrap block that I will use to set the distance between the bars. And what I always do is just go ahead and put a little light tight on these guys here when I'm done, just so they don't rattle off and I lose them. Yeah, I had to gulp when I bought this thing. You know, I actually bought two of them. I got the smaller set, the 400, and then I have the 1000. Well, all I did is just bought the extra two rails, that's right. So I bought the 400 set that had four pieces and the shorties, and then I just bought two extra rails. And they sell some longer rails than this, but this has really done me, this really has just kind of covered everything I want to do. So whether you're cutting, need to make a precision cut for like a router drop-in or what have you, you set this thing up, do your practice cut in a piece of scrap, and when you put it on top of your work, your finished work piece, you are done. You will be what you want it to be. I mean, perfect. Okay, so this is done. These will just go in that one of those big drawers over there in my ultimate work table. So they're just, I'll just, you know, pull that big drawer out and I'll just get some other way in there. Here are the little guys. These are the little sections. These are the 200s, those are the 400s, and these are the 1000s. Right here. But this thing also makes a fantastic big square. When you put it together, you can make a big square for making furniture really square. I've used it before for gluing up big plywood boxes.